guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Harshita and today's video is a popular request video. Most of y'all have been asking me about Jindal scholarships, how to get financial aid, and have shown concerns about the fee of Jindal. So this video is solely pertaining to the different kinds of scholarships or financial aids that you can get in Jindal. It will have a lot of screenshots, screen recordings and links in the description. So make sure you watch it properly and till the end. I would also like to clear it at the outset that this application process and whatever I'm going to be talking about in this video is only pertaining to the Jindal Global Law School and not to the other schools of Jindal. So without further ado, let's get to it. One question that I always get is whether I've received any scholarship from Jindal. So until now, no, I've not received any scholarship. But today is the 27th of September and it is my last day to apply for scholarship for this academic year. So I'm going to be applying for my scholarship today itself. So when I was collecting my documents to apply for the scholarship, I thought of making this video so that it helps you people as well. So first things first, when can you apply for a scholarship? So the first and the most initial type of scholarship is when you sit for your LSAT exam. So Jindal gives scholarship to the people who have topped the LSAT exam or who have the best ranks in that exam. So if you're among the top rankers or the best percentile scorers, then you have a chance to get a scholarship at Jindal, and that scholarship can range from full academic scholarship to 50% of your fee or 40 or 25% of your fee. So this scholarship that you get on the basis of your LSAT score is irrespective of your financial condition. So it is solely based on your merit and your score and nothing else. As far as I remember, people who have scored more than 93 or 94% in the LSAT exam are eligible for this scholarship. But the criteria keeps changing, so you need to look for it. The second type of scholarship is when you're entering law school but you did not get a scholarship solely on the basis of your LSAT exam. So there is a form on the Jindal website where you can apply for a scholarship based on your financial condition, and you're asked to supply them with a lot of relevant documents. They ask for your LSAT application number, your Jindal application number, your LSAT score if you've gotten it already, and details like your class 10 and 12 marks, and they always ask for IT returns. So this type of scholarship also focuses on the financial condition of the applicant and not just the merit. So they have a criteria that the combined parental income of the applicant should be less than 30 lakhs per annum. Only if you have an income less than that, you will be eligible to apply for that scholarship. So this is the form that you're required to fill when you're applying to Jindal Global Law School and seek financial help. This is the place where you need to fill your JGLS application number and LSAT application number. Scrolling down, you can see that they ask for your class 10 and 12 results, and these results can help you in getting the scholarship that you want. You can see that the college gives a lot of importance to the ITR returns that you file, and you need to make sure that you submit the correct ITR and the correct dates. They are very particular about the ITRs that you submit. Other than that, the form asks for basic details like your parents' details and your guardian details. So that's about it for the form.
So these are the two scholarships that one can get while entering law school. Other than that, when you're in your first year, you're not applicable to apply to any other kind of scholarship. Another type of scholarship is the Naveen Jindal Young Global Scholarships.
So basically what happened was, I shot this video on 27th of September, and after that the college changed their website and the scholarships that I was going to talk about are no longer there on the website. So now I have no information whether the scholarships are still available or not. I will surely update you all once I get more information.
Now coming to the scholarships that we can apply for every year. So these are not for the freshers, because the freshers already have scholarships based on their LSAT and the application form that I talked about. So every year in the month of September, the college circulates a link where students who have a certain GPA and want financial support from the college can apply for the merit cum means scholarship at Jindal Global Law School. So this is the scholarship that I'm going to be applying for this time. I had applied for this scholarship last year as well, but there was some issue with the ITR that I had given. They had asked for 3 years, but only 2 year ITR was available with me, and I had also not furnished some other documents that could have helped my application process, such as an LOR or other nominations, due to which the scholarship committee had contacted me to furnish the ITR at a later date, but the ITR was still not available. So I think that made a negative impact on my application process to the committee. Other than that, my GPA and all supported my application. So this year I'm much more prepared, and I'm hoping this application is good. So the things that we asked for in this kind of a form are ITR returns for 3 years, letters of recommendations from different professors, and you can also be nominated by your faculty members if you're into sports, moot courts, etc. So even though this year I was very last minute because of all the things happening in September, like I told you all, it's been a pathetic month. The professors were kind enough to help me with nominations and recommendations. So I had applied for nominations in the moot courts society as well as the sports society. I have been an active member in both the societies, so I had applied for nominations in the both. So I was able to furnish a nomination in the sports society, but I was not able to furnish a nomination in the moot court society because the faculty of that society can only nominate 5 people, and I literally emailed them one day before the last date. But they were kind enough to give me a letter of recommendation because of the achievements and my participation in the society. Other than that, I had emailed a professor that I had been interning under in the month of July. So that professor had agreed to write a letter of recommendation for me. So for the application, I have 1 nomination and 2 letters of recommendations as of now. Other than that, it's not at all a lengthy procedure. You just have to upload the pictures of your ITR, letters of recommendations, nominations. Except that if you're not able to furnish the relevant ITRs, you need to submit a signed declaration. So overall, the application is fairly simple. So now moving on to the financial aid that the college provides. So there is a page on the Jindal Global University website that talks about the financial aid a student can receive. It is detailed and is easy to understand. It also mentions the frequently asked questions so that the students can clear their doubts, and also mentions the documents that one needs to furnish to apply for the financial aid. It also has a built-in calculator where you can do all your calculations for the EMI and the educational loan cost. So I'm going to be attaching the screen recording for the same, and I hope that is helpful. So this is the page that talks about the educational loans on the Jindal Global Law School website. As you can see, there's a built-in calculator where you can calculate all your costs. A document checklist is also available on the website to ensure that you do not miss out on any of the important documents that you need to submit for this kind of a financial aid. Moving on, you can see that the frequently asked questions have been mentioned over there, so that if any person has any doubt pertaining to such questions, it can be solved then and there. So that's about it for the scholarships and the financial aid at Jindal Global Law School. And I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions at all, put it down in the comments. I'd love to get to it and I'll help you all. But other than that, this is all that I have right now. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.